Simon Reynolds, driver of the number 26, former Continental. Yeah, well, this weekend we're just looking for a nice steady weekend. We haven't been in the car since January. The car's been completely rebuilt, and obviously we had the COVID situation, so racing stopped. So it's been a long layoff. So this weekend we're just looking for a nice steady weekend. Really not treating it as a race. We're trying to treat it as a practice session, just to get my my eye back in, get my feet back underneath myself, see what we have in the car, and go from there. I'm just going to be working on lines and just trying to be smooth. Obviously getting familiar with the track again, but more than that, really getting familiar with the car again. Yeah, it's a nice little track, fairly close to home, obviously. Been here one time before. So, I like the track. It's got a nice, interesting little section. Probably the most important section as far as lap time is concerned is the back section where they have the S's into a sweeping right-hander before a long straight. So that's really a key area for lap times. And when I came here last time, I don't think I got that right one time. So that'll be an important area of the track for me to try and work on technique right there.
So have you had new brakes on the car before? Okay, so what you'll do is while you may be on your reconnaissance lap, you know, look in your mirrors and make sure that there's nobody directly behind you, right on top of you. And if you want, you can fall back. But what I think you want to do is when there's nobody behind you, accelerate, stab the brake. Mm-hmm. Do it maybe two or three times on that lap. And after that, you should be pretty much ready to roll. Trying to do is any resins that might be in the pad material, kind of want to fake them off before you go kneading them.
I was going to try and ride them a little bit initially too.
Yeah, you can.
It was awesome to get back in the car. Felt great. Felt rusty, but it felt good too. It was a really good session. Had a lot of fun. The car was really, really good. A lot better than I thought it was going to be. I thought I was going to have some brake issues, so that made me a little nervous to start with, but they cleared up, and the car behaved really well. It instilled a lot of confidence. I would say it took me probably three or four laps just to get a little bit of confidence back in, and then it was a case of the car was instilling a little bit too much confidence, so I had to just dial it back a little bit and let the testosterone cool a little and let the red mist disappear a little bit. Yeah, we did the best lap we've ever done here. Qualified second overall and first in class. So yeah, it was pretty good. But I think that's more down to the car. In fact, it was down to the car more than me. So I think once we build a little more confidence and looking at, you know, analyzing certain corners where I was losing a little, I think it'll be good. But it bodes well. That would definitely be in turn five. It's a big long right-hand horseshoe. Tricky entry. I'm not really brave enough on the entry at the moment, and the exit kind of it unnerves me a little because the camber goes away on the exit, so I always feel like I'm hedging and holding back a little bit to counter that. Big threat is rain. We just got the rain tires out of the truck. I think it's going to be heavy rain all day, so that changes everything. So yes, we'll just have to dial it back and just plod around and make sure we get a finish, I think, will be the best plan.
All the work we did, you know, wasn't that much. Changing sway bars, things like that, tires and whatnot. You could do that until you're blue in the face. And then something like a throttle position sensor bites you in the butt. It's like being blindsided and never seeing the linebacker coming.
It was okay in the paddock driving out, and then come the green flag, hit the throttle, and we didn't go anywhere. Lots of backfiring and missing. So we just spent the rest of the race driving around, logging laps with a really bad misfire. So hey, that's racing. That's a little frustrating, to say the least. You're just driving around trying to avoid the puddles and watching your mirrors.
We came in with very little expectation simply because of the shortened, you know, no practice on Friday, it was canceled, and the compressed schedule. There's only three outings that we planned to have all together. We just wanted to make sure that the car was underneath him, that he would feel comfortable. Car came off a complete rebuild, down to the bare chassis, and you know, I've been telling him since the process started, the car's gonna feel so much better, so different. And I'm happy he had a dry session yesterday. He was able to verify that. And he set a PR in what, 10 laps? You know, so I think he did really well.
I'm gonna take away that yesterday's session was really, really good. A lot better than I expected. The car felt really good. I felt like I got back up to speed reasonably quickly. I have confidence in the car and built a little confidence in myself after being out of the cockpit for so long. So it was a good takeaway. Unfortunate for today, but hey, if it was easy, everybody would be doing it. I'd like to thank John and Dave Daddario right here for everything. Again, you know, without them, it doesn't happen, so appreciate them. And Paul Riffle, give a shout out to him for building a really nice car.
I wish it wasn't raining, yeah, because that, but at the same time, it exposed the weakness that we would have been ignorant of. So, you know, it's a low pressure weekend. We got credit for a finish. The car's in one piece. I think it's not a blessing, but it was something that we could build on and make the car better. Why does it always rain on me? Is it because I lied when I was 17? Why does it always rain on me? Even when the sun is shining, I can't afford the light.